Welcome to another video from the school data series of TMS Web Core examples. This demo will add design to an example that we already built. We added markers to a map, and these markers were based on a data set that was accessed using XData. This demo is part of the school series. I mark all these videos with these wonderful happy students. Just so you know, there's a part one, part two, and so on. Here you see what we already built. We built a web application that shows a map, and on this map you find all the schools. You could hover over all the schools and get information. And in the last video I had like design question mark, and now you're gonna get design exclamation mark. So now I'm gonna introduce you how you can build design to a TMS web application like a professional web developer. So before you actually can begin transferring or writing your HTML or CSS, you need to have some kind of idea what your application is supposed to look like. You need a grid, because Bootstrap is based on grids. In order to build this grid, you need to find rows and columns. And I honestly can't give you an explanation of Bootstrap, but what helped me immensely, and I'm going to refer this only once, and I honestly don't get any money for it, there's a webpage called Bring Your Own Laptop. On this webpage, you find a course for web design, and what helped me immensely is that I learned how to build web pages with Photoshop. That was one of these here, how to design a website in Photoshop. And the next one that is available is building responsive Bootstrap websites. And these courses, they basically explain to you why you need a prototype first, what you can do with a prototype, and how you can transfer this prototype into CSS and HTML. Of course, this is all built on Adobe tools, so not everyone might have these Adobe tools available. I'm just showing you one of the ways. Of course, you can do this with GIMP or any other open source alternative. And you might not even want to do this, but you have to tell somebody what you need. So you need to give them instructions or her instructions. So you have to be able to describe what you need. And this is what this video will also tell you. It will tell you what you need to tell your web designer, what you need from him or her. Okay, so this is the design that I did, and you can clearly see we have like rows, like here this is a header row, and in this header row I have basically 1, 2, and 3 columns, and then we follow up with the map and the center extending through the whole screen, so one column basically, and here we have like logos, TMS software company logo, my own company logo. So, and these are basically flush to the right next of each other. So this template is also actually from bringyouronlaptop.com, because it allows me to show the columns from the Bootstrap template. And that is so helpful, you have no idea. So here we go. Let's see, we want, like, for example, let's say you have 3 columns. You see that we have 1, 2, 3. And then you can see how to align your stuff. So you basically see if we use 3 columns, my logos are in the rightmost column. I could align it like that. So that gives you an impression how to align it. And it also, what this course also teaches you is how to align your rulers so that you immediately see like 960 pixels. This is like for a web application, that's for a desktop. And of course, and this is also cool, you could also build for other devices, for example, tablet and mobile. And this template allows you to do the design for that as well. And as you see here, Dan loves Adobe. That's the creator from bringyourownlaptop.com. And these courses teach you how to do it. Of course, it's only an introduction to Bootstrap. Bootstrap can do much more. So here we see the whole finished design in Dreamweaver. And again, I can't explain Dreamweaver to you in a 10-minute video, but you see here we have the boxes, 1, 2, and the one in the middle. And all the, and this makes it so wonderful, all the fonts and all these definitions, they have been taken from Photoshop. I really get the same design that I get in Photoshop in Dreamweaver by following certain rules with Bootstrap. What I owe to tell you now, how would you get this into TMS Web? Getting all this into TMS Web is really, really easy. First of all, your custom CSS added to the project. Then also right-click the project and select the JavaScript Libraries Manager. And there you see you can enable Bootstrap and jQuery and all other JavaScript frameworks that TMS looked at and basically included in TMS Web Core right away. So as soon as I add this, all the references to Bootstrap, jQuery are being done by the framework. I don't even have to think about it. That means my project 1HTML, which is the global HTML file for the whole web application, it includes the references if you switch to code to the Bootstrap servers. So that's number one. And our form still looks the same. And this might surprise you. It still looks the same. It's still the same form. I have my map and my two data sets. But if I run my application, and this will certainly surprise you, I get this view. And this is actually interactive, and I have a different icon here. So how did I do this? And this is where you have to communicate with your web designer. And an example speaks louder than any manual text or book that you can read. So this map has, if you look in the object inspector, in the properties, and of course my wonderful API key is visible again, it has an element ID. And I called it ID map. And this is what I, as the programmer, either tell the web designer to use, or the web designer tells you, hey, for this area, meaning if I go back to Dreamweaver, this area here is called, if you look in the HTML code, is called ID map. No matter which way it works, you have to basically figure out a process how to determine how to name your HTML elements that you want to share with applications. So this is ID map. And as soon as I make this determination, the map will be linked to that area. However, there's one more thing to do, of course. How does the HTML get there? Of course, the unit 1 Pascal file with its like Delphi-like designer also has an HTML file attached, and this HTML file actually gets the code from Dreamweaver. So you copy paste it over, and you remove the Bootstrap references, because you have your Bootstrap references right here. That's a little bit of cleaning up that you have to do, but everything else you keep it like you designed it in Dreamweaver, and then you start your application and it's going to show up as designed. And this also works, for example, you see here Google APIs fonts. I use Google Web Fonts to improve the design. I use the Roboto font. You see the Roboto font right here. This is not a graphic. I didn't cheat, you know. And still, we have all the interaction. We can zoom. So that is all still there. We still have the ability to switch into Street View and do all that kind of stuff. What else did I do? I also added this logo. And that is actually the last thing I'm going to explain to you. So this logo is a PNG file, and I added the PNG file. Actually, I added two with different sizes to the project. There we go. So my call, the at marker call, I changed it. Still both coordinates, and I use like the briefcase 24 PNG. And if I, for example, use the 32 PNG, should get bigger, significantly bigger. That's why I changed it. Yeah, you see, too big if you ask me. So that's why I changed it to this with the smaller ones. So 24. It's important to note, if you add a graphic like this briefcase to the root of your project, it will also be deployed to the root of your deployed application. For example, if you put something into the images folder, you would have to type like dot slash images slash, okay? So that's the deployment of that is being done by the IDE automatically if you compile the application. You also see, and I forgot that previously to mention it, here, of course, are all the graphics that you reference in your HTML. That means, like, for example, if you have here a graphic, like here, image source, images seal of Florida, PNG, of course, you need to have in your images directory, seal of Florida, PNG. And again, as soon as you add it to your project, it's being deployed. And if we look at the Explorer, which I'm going to do right now, let's see, we have show in Explorer. When we go to the TMS web app, and there you see debug, and this images folder is actually being transformed over there. And you have all the different graphics, and you see I did a couple of tests with different designs, and here you see the 24 and 32 icons. That means, like, if you deploy multiple versions, the old versions, of course, are never being cleaned up. So these are all my developer iterations from the design that I fiddled around with. But it also shows you, I really show you the real deal. I'm not showing you something that's prepared and that's not been developed by myself over a process to give you the best learning experience for TMS web. So there you have it. So the key points are, as soon as you have a graphical control, you can tie it to your design using the element ID. With this element ID, it means the element inside of your HTML, meaning this file, is being replaced with this. Meaning you can use whatever control in your HTML. Web designers usually use a div tag if it's an area, but this is also true, and I might show this at a later time, to get some interaction in there that you can use, for example, buttons and edit controls, and you place them in your design as empty frames. And as soon as you and you design your IDs for these empty frames, and then you hook up these empty frames to, I don't know, combo boxes, list boxes in your HTML. TMS web actually comes with a very basic Bootstrap example in the box, which is in the demo folder under basics, Bootstrap. And we have a separate video for this if you're interested. So you can see it right here that we style different components. Please go to that video and get a detailed introduction to that video. In the last two videos, we've done mapping and we've done design. So let's look at another great component from Google, Google Charts. So next time we're going to do charting with school data. And I'm going to do something like student numbers per zip code. And for that, we will also have to extend our X-Data server with a custom method that allows us to retrieve certain records that are represented by a different query. And of course, we can simply send a SQL query to our X-Data server. So we extend the X-Data server with a special method that is being used by our charting application. And that's something we're going to digest. And then we have our records again that we can iterate in order to create our chart. But more about that in the next video. Stay tuned. I hope you are fascinated by how easy it is to design TMS Web Core applications. See you soon.